Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am explaining you file handling in C++. In this current video session, I am explaining you one of the primitive operation is nothing but the how to perform read operation to a file. Before moving to the content, if you have not still subscribe my channel, please subscribe it and keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you a notification of new videos of my channel. Do share it with your friends and like the video as well. Now let's start with the primitive operations on file. So which are the primitive operations we can perform on a file? They are, first of all, creation of file or opening of file. After creating or after opening a file, we'll use that file by performing reading and writing operation. After performing reading and writing operation, we have to close a file. So opening of file, read a file, write onto the file and close a file are the basic primitive operations that we can perform on a file. To perform all these operations, you must have to keep in mind that you have to include ifstream and fstream header files into your source code. Without inserting all these files or both the files, you can't proceed in your program. Now let's start with the next important concept, is nothing but the file pointer. So the file pointer is a pointer which is always maintained whenever you are going to open any of the file for reading or writing purpose or for any another purpose. Always a file pointer is maintained with every file. That file pointer, why we need to maintain? Because that file pointer keeps the track of the current position of the cursor in the current file, which is helpful to perform reading operation or a writing operation on a file. Whenever you are going to perform these operations, that is reading and writing, onto the file, automatically this file pointer will get incremented. We, the programmer, no need to update it or increment it. Now let's start with the reading onto the file. We are going to focus on the reading primitive operation in this current video. Before going to perform the reading operation, I would like to explain you how to perform this reading, or what is reading actually, reading from a file. Now let's consider this is the file, you are having a data with three integer values. That three integer values are stored into a file in consecutive locations. If I want to read this information from a file, I will copy the content of the first value or first position from a file into the variable x, for example. Then I will move forward to the next position, I will copy this information into the another variable, and again the file pointer will get advanced to the next position and it will copy the content of the file to the third variable, that is z. So the data is copied from the file into the variable is nothing but the reading operation onto the file. So this is nothing but the input function, where we are taking the input from the file. Whenever we are going to perform the reading operation, now how we can perform this read operation? For this, we are going to use the extraction operator, just same as of your C in object of the ifstream, where only you need to keep in mind that instead of taking the information from keyboard, you are reading the information from the file. So that's why to access this extraction operator, we need the object of either ifstream class or fstream class, because these both are the streams which are useful while performing the read operation. So instead of using C in object, we will use the object or a file pointer, which is nothing but the object of the ifstream class or the fstream class. So what is the syntax that I am going to explain you in this example, where let's see, this is nothing but the ifstream, because purely I am going to perform only the read operation on the file. So ifstream, I am going to make the file pointer in file, is nothing but the object of the ifstream class. So with the help of this variable or the object or the file pointer, I am going to open a file. Here I am going to open a file in read mode. By default it is a read mode. Here I am going to read the content of the file. That's why I am going to use the object of ifstream class and the extraction operator and data. So in this data variable, the content of the file will get copied. And with the cout statement, we are writing the data onto the output screen. Whatever is data read from the file will get out onto the screen. After that, the next data I am going to read from the file with the help of in file pointer. That data I am going to out again onto the screen. In this way, I can perform the read operation from the file. After performing all the tasks, I need to close my file. How to open a file is already explained in my previous video, opening modes. Here in that opening modes, I have explained the different opening modes, and in the primitive operations in which open and close, I have explained the syntax for the both. So in this way, we can perform the reading from the file. The applications where we can use the reading operation. So if I want to implement the application of the read function, then in which way I can use? So whenever if I want to search any of the record from my file for which I have to read the content of the file. Searching is nothing but the comparison for which where the data is stored is nothing but the file. So from the file, I'll read the record one by one. I'll compare it with the search key, and in this way I can perform the searching operation. Another application is nothing but the deleting. In the deleting operation, we need to perform again the searching, because the record which I want to delete, that first of all I need to search. After searching that particular record, if the record found, then I will delete that record. So for in the deleting also, in the half part, for the searching of particular record, we need to read the file. So that's why in the deleting also we are going to perform the read operation. So these are very basic applications where we are going to use the reading of the file primitive operation. Thank you friends for listening and watching my video. I hope you are understanding the concept of primitive operations on the files. For the next session, next part of the video, I am providing you a shortcut link over here. I am providing here the playlist for this current video session, file handling in C++, as well as I am providing you a subscription link in this area. Please do subscribe my channel. Stay tuned for the next concepts. Thank you friends.